defense. That's what you mean by nonviolent. Be defenseless. Be defenseless in the face of one of the most cruel beasts that has ever taken the people into captivity. That's this American white man. And they have proved it throughout the country by the police dogs and the police clubs. 100 years ago, they used to put on a white sheet and use a bloodhound against Negroes. Today, they have taken off the white sheet and put on police uniforms. They've traded in the bloodhounds for police dogs, and they're still doing the same thing. And just as Uncle Tom, back during slavery, used to keep the Negroes from resisting the bloodhound or resisting the Ku Klux Klan by teaching them to love their enemy or pray for those who use them despitefully. Today, Martin Luther King is just a 20th century or modern Uncle Tom or a religious Uncle Tom who is doing the same thing today to keep Negroes defenseless in the face of attack that Uncle Tom did on the plantation to keep those Negroes defenseless in the face of the attack of the Klan in that
day. I don't think of love as, in this context, as emotional bosh. I don't think of it as a weak force, but I think of love as something strong and that organizes itself in powerful direct action. This is what I try to teach in the struggle in the South, that we are not engaged in a struggle that means we sit down and do nothing. That there's a great deal of difference between non-resistance to evil and non-violent resistance. Non-resistance leaves you in a state of stagnant passivity and deadening complacency, wherein non-violent resistance means that you do resist in a very strong and determined manner.
Now, let's focus in on that phrase. Hands up, don't shoot. Meaning that we are trying to make those that do not comprehend the value of a black life comprehend that value. Now there is an enemy in this fight. Don't let anyone tell you otherwise. The enemy is the social construct of race, which has led to the concrete creation of what is known as racism. The enemy is the lines of reasoning which linger within the minds of those who do not comprehend the value of a black life. The reason we chant, the reason we protest, the reason we speak is so that we can combat the diseased mind of the country which we occupy. You cannot ignore the voices of millions in pain in the year 2016. It is impossible. But I'll leave you with this.
As college students, in your youth, You are standing on the greatest platform for which your voice can be heard. All I ask of you is that you use it. Thank you.
That's what I'm talking about.
If I'm going to be real with you right now at this moment, I was able to see you for who you really are. You have an ability. A gift, rather, to inspire people, to lead them. I didn't realize to what extent you were able to do so until this moment. I see you standing here, and I know that you're a man with the ability to change the world.
Up there, beyond the sky. It's been a long time coming, but I know a change gonna come. Oh, yes it will. I go to the movie, and I go downtown. Somebody keep telling me no.
There are no consequences to this life that I've chosen to live. I've inspired hope, haven't I? I feel as though the people can do more than just wait around to be slaughtered like cattle.
Yeah, you seem to keep telling yourself that. It seems as though you just can't come to grips with the fact that you fucking failed. You're a coward. You tremble at the sight of your own shadow. What are you talking about? Take that fucking mask off! I'm tired of looking at it! The more hearts we touch with our message, the louder our voice will become. You know damn well that's bullshit! Okay. You want to talk about purpose? You want to talk about what I'm supposed to do? You want to tell me that I fucking failed? Fuck that! You don't know! You don't know what it's like to be judged every day by your failures. Searching for answers that I don't even know exist, to problems that can't even be solved. And you want to call me a false prophet? I know you don't believe that the world can be changed with a couple of mindless protests. But you have no problem endangering those that do. You're a fucking failure. I hate everything that you've become. You ain't shit, David!